Hey guys, this is Neil Davis from Digital Cloud Training. AWS are releasing a new version of the AWS Certified DevOps Professional Certification Exam. It's the DOP-C02. And in this video, I'm going to talk about what it is and how you should best prepare yourself for the new exam. The new exam, of course, is still a professional level exam, and it's also 180 minutes long, as it always has been. And you get 75 questions. The cost is $300. Now, don't forget that if you've passed an exam before, an AWS exam, you do get a voucher, which you can use to discount your exam by 50%. So you bring it down to $150. You can either take your test in a testing center, or you can take it online from home or your office. The scoring system is a scaled scoring system between 100 and 1,000 points, and you need to achieve 750 points to pass the exam. Now, this is a comparison of the exam domains between the DOP C01 and C02, the newer exam on the right-hand side. So you can see that some of them map precisely, like the SDLC automation, that's the software development lifecycle automation, which maps exactly between domain 1 and domain 1 of the new exam, and the same weighting as well at 22%. The next one is also very similar. They've just abbreviated the infrastructure as code to IAC. Slightly different weighting. Then we have Resilient Cloud Solutions, a new one in the DOP C02. So the domains are changing a bit here. Monitoring and logging, very similar. It was domain 3 in the old exam, same weighting as well. Then we've got Incident and Event Response. Again, pretty much maps across to domain 5, except the weighting being slightly different. And then we've got Security and Compliance as well. You can look all of this up in more detail on the exam guide for the DOP C02, and this gives you all the detail you might want. So you can see the response type, so multiple choice and multiple response. Those are the only two options. There's no exam labs or hands-on component. It's pure questions with responses. And by the way, there are 10 unscored items. So 65 questions are scored and 10 of them are not. You've then got the content outline, so the domains we just looked at. And if you want to go into some more detail, you can see all of the different task statements within each of these domains here as well. And what I'm going to do now is scroll down and have a quick look at the services that are in scope for this exam. In the appendix here, we can see which key tools, technologies, and concepts might be covered on the exam. Of course, there's quite a few different categories here. And this is an increased number of services compared to the DOP C01. So there's quite a lot of new services like AWS App2 Container and Copilot, which have been added in. The Red Hat OpenShift service on AWS, just to give you a couple of examples. So AWS are constantly releasing new services and features. And when they do a new version of the exam, that's typically when they start adding those into the curriculum of this certification. So quite a lot of services are covered in this exam. You will need to do a bit of extra study compared to the DOP C01. Now let's cover off a couple of key dates. The last day to take the current exam is March the 6th, 2023. And the first day to take the updated exam is March 7th, 2023. Let's finish off with a few frequently asked questions. Do I need to recertify? Well, you don't unless your certification is actually expiring soon. There's a 3-year validity period. At the end of that, you do need to recertify. Is there an exam lab component? No, there is no exam lab component, nothing hands-on in this exam. When will the Digital Cloud Training course be updated? We're going to release new practice questions into our course before the exam is released, and then we'll be adding more over time as we get feedback from what's coming up in the exam. You don't need to purchase again if you have an active subscription. If you're already studying for the DOP C01 and you're wondering whether you should switch to learning the new topics and taking the CO2, it doesn't really matter which exam you take because the exam code is not put in your certification. So it's more a matter of when are you going to be ready to pass the exam. If you're comfortably ready before the expiry of the existing exam, then do it. Otherwise, just study for the new version and make sure you learn those extra topics.